Hi, and welcome back to part two of the Film Impact Animation Series. We're going to talk about dynamic animations, and I'm going to show you how to create this animation entirely within Premiere Pro. So again, this beautiful animation, this house-drawn figure, is created entirely within Premiere Pro, and let's show you how this is done. I'm basically using a PSD, a Photoshop file, and this file has all separate elements on different layers of this graphic. And you know, eventually we've got the color fill and the background all on separate layers within this Photoshop file. So let's import it into Premiere. There you go. And here's the house draw PSD. I'm going to drag it in there. And this is an important dialogue, by the way. Premiere is asking how to what to do with this particular Photoshop file. It wants to merge all layers, but we don't want it. We want all the layers individually and work with that. So that's why we're going to do import as sequence. There you go. And now we've got a folder with all the separate elements, and all the way at the bottom we'll find the sequence, and let's double click that. So this is the sequence with all the separate elements being spread out over the video tracks. So basically we see the same thing, all the layers inside of Premiere, and this allows you to apply video transitions to each element separately. So let's do that. Let's go to the top element and apply the pop motion video transition to it and see how that works. It's the little arrow here, by the way, on the right side of the roof. So you can see that popping up. It's growing and it's creating that dynamic bounce. So it's doing the overshoot, as can be seen here. And we can apply this to each and every single layer. So how that's done, it's going to be selected, copy, command drag, and you might not be able to see that, but there's a red bar indicating that we've selected the left side, the left cut of each element, and just paste it there. So there you go, and see how that works. So there you go. And now we've got everything moving at once, right? And that's not what I would call dynamic. I would create a like an offset and work with the timing to really create that dynamic look. So again, we're going to move back to the sequence and select every element, and on the keyboard hit plus one, and this will move each layer, each selected layer, just one frame to the right. And shift click will deselect the lower part, and again do plus one to just have that thing move over. And we're going to repeat this process, and this is going to be the nudge in time. I would suggest doing one, maybe two frames there, depending on the frames per second you're working with. But I mean, try one, especially if you have like 10 or more tracks here, and almost at the very top, and here it's the last one. So I created a little bit of a stair, right? And going back and see how that works. So that's looking better, right? And we might be, you know, this yellow area might be too much and too much in your face. Why not move it a little bit to the right side and wait for it to reveal, and maybe create a dissolve there, because that'll be prettier, I guess. There you go. Oh, that's beautiful. See how this dynamically grows? It's playful. It's bouncy. If you're somehow unhappy with this movement, you can select the one of the transitions, basically anyone, and fiddle with the controls. So I'm going to increase the frequency here, and as you can see, it worked very playful, and increase the amplitude, so 77, maybe even increase the duration there. And again, I'm gonna select it, copy it, command drag. And we have selected every cut on the beginning and do a paste. And we'll apply it quickly to each separate layer. And going back and see the result, that's amazing, right? So you might not get real-time playback. Even though the yellow bar indicates real-time performance, we have been stacking up to 16 layers of video transitions. So your computer might or might not keep up. You can play with the resolution, change it to half or even quarter resolution to see how that works for you. So that's pretty good. But again, I would recommend setting an in point, an out point, and make a render into out, and that will create a preview render. It will perform real time, full res, full quality. And again, this animation is entirely made inside your favorite editing application. So there you go. Doesn't that look good? So this is the way to create dynamic animations with the Film Impact Animation Series. Hope you liked this video. See you next time. Bye.